Nos encontramos con Cres. Ella ha visitado la Escuela Niño Jesús. ¿Cuál ha sido tu experiencia?
Here we are with Cres. She has visited the School Niño Jesús. What was your experience?
It was a very pleasant day for me. Why I came all the way from Kenya was to learn lessons that other people have learned, so that I can carry the same to my country and to the project that I undertake. So the main thing that I learned today was, there were actually 5 points. The first point was sustainability. There was a point on intercultural exchange. There is also a point on gender. There is efficiency in the children. And then there is also the sharing of platform, which we may develop to teachers. So on the first one, about sustainability, the main thing that appeared there was that the teachers and the parents and the entire school community actually work together. You can see it from the parent representative that they actually contribute to the maintenance of the lab and the trainer. And when you look also at the children, they come to the classroom knowing this is a place that they must maintain and they must keep clean. They remove their shoes, they go in very nicely and very orderly. So that shows also a future in the maintenance of the equipment around them, and that they really understand what it means to keep the equipment maintained. The second one on efficiency about the children, there was confidence. You know, they are told to do a research on a certain topic, and they know how to go about it. It's something that it doesn't take them time. So there is efficiency, there is commitment, there is confidence, which does not start at one point. It started over a long period of basic skills acquisition by the children in IT, and then gradually they go into the use of ICT for sharing information. This takes us now to the point where there is a creation of a platform. We can, as partners, start exploring the possibility of having a network of teachers to undertake the sharing of information on various things, not just waiting for a global teenager platform like the one that we've seen, but start having teachers coordinate among one another. The last one that I can talk about is gender. We observed also something that is very interesting and similar to our application also in Africa, is that women really do a lot of participation. They participate a lot when it comes to matters of education. So is that also a chance for us in ICT to start developing issues that affect gender and that can carry forward the advancement of gender issues among partners and in the communities that we work for? I think that is actually something very useful that we've learned today. Thank you very much.
Gracias a ti.
So we're here with Roberto. He visited today the Simón Bolívar School, where they showed a couple of educational games.
Aquí estamos con Roberto. Él visitó el colegio Simón Bolívar y observó algunos juegos didácticos.
Bueno, estos juegos son parte de un kit de software educativo que se usa con niños de primaria y principalmente orientado a mejorar las capacidades de lectura, ¿no? Los niños leen, posteriormente responden cuestionarios para ver qué tanto han comprendido y cómo pueden articular la enseñanza de estos textos o los cuentos que ellos leen o las enseñanzas que se dan a través de este software. Y también podemos ver que los niños tienen mucho interés en este software. Es muy importante la ayuda del profesor o profesora, puesto que los orienta, los organiza y hace que todos puedan seguir a un mismo ritmo, ¿no? Y podemos ver que la aplicación también ayuda a que ellos puedan aprender jugando y puedan experimentar de diferentes formas el mismo tema.
And what was the thing that opened your eyes the most today?
Comentar de qué manera han participado también.
Bueno, los diferentes niños y niñas van cada uno a su ritmo, ¿no? No se puede querer que todos vayan al mismo ritmo. Unos van más rápido de acuerdo al interés, a la capacidad que ellos tienen. Sin embargo, el juego permite tener diferentes niveles de aprendizaje y cada uno va avanzando de acuerdo a su ritmo.
Ok, gracias.
De nada.
Estamos con David. Él ha visitado la escuela El Carmen y nos va a contar en qué consiste la experiencia y cuáles son sus impresiones.
Here we are with David, who has visited the school El Carmen, and he is going to express what he saw there and share with us some of his experiences.
Thank you. Like you said, I'm David. We went out to El Carmen School in Yapakani, and we majorly did two things. One, classroom observation. We found out that in the classroom, there was a more interactive, participatory, and child-centered environment. Another thing is that the teaching material was available in the classroom, be it equipment, computer, and the other teaching material produced by the teacher. We also had interviews with the teacher and realized that the teacher generated the content for the lessons, and this content came from the ideas that the learners put up. So the learners wrote the stories, and the teacher generated this and set up onto the computer, onto the program. Another thing we learned is that the teachers had a teacher support platform that is for this district, and that is a good thing. And they had regular peer training. And by this, the teacher gave us a report showing that there is performance improvement by 20%. It was a great trip, but we have things we've learned from. I will majorly talk on the challenges that we might face. Teachers back home would be great to use this, but one thing we should put into consideration is to build their capacity to be able to incorporate or integrate ICT into their day-to-day teaching processes. This is majorly what we saw today. Thank you.